Hey guys, how's it going? Today is art class number 26, and we're going to be doing abstract art. So somebody's going to ask, okay, what is abstract art? Well, I'll give it a short version. Abstract art uses visual language of shapes, forms, color, and line. That's the short version. And the longer version, I guess once you get older, you'll learn about the longer version of abstract art. So today, got a large sheet of paper here. 18 by 24 poster board. This is a T-square. You can use this in drafting and in other forms of art. This is a compass or protractor, and what it is that you take this out, you put this in this slot here, you tighten it up. Pencil goes in there, tighten it up on it, over here on this. And then you just make a circle. But what I might use is a pen so that the line will be dark enough to see. And I got a few colors in there. Orange, green, purple, black, red, and blue. I think brown. So, let's get started. So first, I'm going to do like a triangular shape using a black marker. An abstract art, it could be anything you want it to be. It could be shapes, it could be like different colors made into shapes. At the end of the art class, I might show you a painting that I did where the whole painting is abstract. There's some realism in it, but it's mostly abstract. So first, I'm gonna do something like this. Goes that way. Line goes this way. Make it connect. A rectangle shape. So that's going to be like that. So I'll let you guys figure out what kind of shape I'm gonna do next. Another one of these somewhere, and you're able to tighten up the pen or pencil that you're going to use so that it won't slip out that way. In this abstract, you could pretty much do whatever you want to do. I mean, there's no real rule as to how long a line should be or how wide the line's supposed to be. Yeah, I see it as total freedom to do whatever you want to do. So In this case, I'm going to make this circle into a clock. Anybody can tell me what number goes here. Yep, you guessed it. And here. Yep. You guys are good. Here. And here. Now I'll get to the hard part. What number goes here? Good job, guys. And here. The number's getting higher. What goes here? And here. Good counting, guys. So this also can be used in math as well, to find out what area you're trying to figure out. As you get older, you learn about that as well. So I got my clock. Put a little dot here. And I put the shorthand on the I know what time that is. Shorthand on the 8, longhand on the 12. You guessed it, 8 o'clock. So now I'm going to take some colors and color in a couple spots. Let's see here. Thank you. I guess the nice thing about doing abstract art is you can create your own shapes and color them in. Color doesn't matter. You can use any color you want. Cool thing about abstract art also, you can use the same color in different places. Like over here, I'm gonna put blue here as well. Maybe another spot I can use blue. Where can I use it? Finish with the blue. And now, I think I'll use red. Where can I use red at? How about here? Can I use red? How about over here? And you can overlap colors too, creating your own colors. Like for instance, you got blue and red. Now let's say, I did blue. Here, and I use the color blue here. Now, what color would I get if I mix blue and red? Don't anybody call out the answer at once. It's supposed to be green. Oh, is it supposed to be purple? Yeah, looks more like purple. Not really sure what else I want to do with this, but what I can do is get a little more creative, start adding something else to these shapes. This is where a T-square comes in handy. Whenever you have a T-square, you can always use the cross part of the T-square at the edge of the table. So let's say you want to draw a line like I'm doing now. And get a perfect line every time. So that part is lined. What about the other areas? Oh, let's see. Should be a thin line or a wider line. Should I go right through it or stop? You guys, but it's starting to look pretty interesting. Thank you. probably get really creative and let me see. What do I have in mind now? Get really creative and use a section. Use like a corner and just make a line across other lines. For instance, should I use a blue or black? Yes, I think I'll take black. This point here. This is going to be in our other art class when I'm using the same point. I'll tell you what that is in my next art class. Should I go through that triangle or skip over it? Let's see. Shapes within a shape. Okay. It's all about doing whatever you want to do in abstract art. I think I use a black for this one. This space, these two spaces don't have anything. So I'm thinking of extending it from one shape to another using a point. Skip over here and continue here. I believe I'm finished. Take a look at what I have. So, what should I call this masterpiece? Any names, guys? Don't shout all at once. I'm sure those names are pretty good, but I was thinking of abstract clock. Clock here, abstract all around it. It's the only name I could come up with at the time. Anyway, this is art class number 26. Hope you enjoyed it. I'll see you later.